Welcome to VLSI lecture series. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you on-chip clock generation in this video. So to understand on-chip clock generation, first I'll explain you basics of clock signal in digital integrated circuit, where we will see different parameters of clock signal and basics of clock signal. After that, I'll explain you primary clock generator. In that, Pierre's crystal oscillator will get explained you in detail. And at last, I'll explain how we can have generation of two non-overlapping clocks. So these are my session outlines. Let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of clock in digital integrated circuit. So when we talk about clock signal, it is heartbeats of digital system. So when we talk about sequential circuit, then it is highly essential to have clock signal, otherwise sequential circuit cannot function. So clock signals are heartbeats of digital system, and it is highly essential to have stability of clock signal, else our system may get fail in digital integrated circuit. So clock signals are referred as heartbeats of digital system. Now first, let us try to understand how ideal clock will look like. See, clock signals should have minimum rise time and fall time, and it should have specified duty cycle. And it should have zero skew. So first of all, one should know what is rise time, fall time, duty cycle and skew of the clock. Then one can understand what is ideal clock. So here I'm just giving you an example of clock. You see, practically clock will look like this. In that, here clock signal is having lower amplitude, and here clock signal is having higher amplitude. So if you observe this delay, which is required to have transition from lower amplitude to higher amplitude, is referred as rise time of clock. And if you observe this delay, where it requires to have transition from higher amplitude to lower amplitude, is referred as fall time. In ideal clock signal, this rise time and fall time should be zero. Practically it is not possible, so one can say it should be as minimum as possible. Now I'll explain you skew of the clock. Now see, in digital integrated circuit, we provide clock signal to many blocks. So sometimes clock signal may get arrive at different block with different delay. So let us have one example. You see, here we have a clock signal which is arrived at second block by blue color. You are observing it. And if you observe the delay in between first clock, which is there by this black color, and by this blue color, then that delay is referred as skew. So it is highly essential to have synchronization of all clocks which is there in integrated circuit. If there is a delay in between block, then there is a possibility of false operation. So ideally skew should be zero. So here you see, skew is what? It is what delayed version of clock with respect to the clock which is given to primary block. Now let us try to understand what is duty cycle. So here, if you observe this clock, in that this time period is T on time period, where signal is active high. And if you observe this time period, then that is T off time period, where signal is active low. So duty cycle, that is T on divided by T on plus T off. So this is what duty cycle. In 99% of digital integrated circuit, you will be finding duty cycle is 50%. So it should be well defined before we operate with clock signal in digital integrated circuit. Most of the cases you will be finding this clock signal will be having 50% of duty cycle. Now let us discuss some other basics which is there with digital integrated circuit. See, practically you will be finding there is a noticeable rise time and fall time, and sometimes you'll be finding duty cycle even may vary. So what we do is, when we use clock signal in digital integrated circuit, at that time we expand our machine cycle by 10% so that realistic clock skew can be operated with proper operation in computer system. The reason is, computer system will be very complex. And in that, there will be finite amount of rise time, fall time, as well as somewhat variation may be there in duty cycle, and to overcome all those issues along with skew, all we do is we expand machine cycle by 10%. So for example, if you have machine cycle which is there with total time period here of 1 microsecond, then we expand it by 10%, so new machine cycle that will be 1.1 microsecond. On-chip clock generation will be process dependent and it may make your system unstable. So in most of the cases, externally we generate clock signal and then we apply it to high performance VLSI chip. So in most of the situation, you'll be finding we don't generate clock on chip, but all we do is we generate it externally and then we feed it to VLSI circuits. So these are the basics which is there with digital integrated circuit. Now let us have a clock generator. So primarily you'll be finding there are basically three techniques which we use it to generate clock. One is Pierce clock generator, second is ring oscillator, and third is LC tank oscillator circuit. See, this ring oscillator that I'll be explaining you with separate session, and LC tank oscillator circuit that has L and C in parallel combination that you might have studied in basic electronics, so that I'm not going to discuss it over here. Here we will see Pierce clock generator in detail. So let us have Pierce clock generator in detail. So if you observe this Pierce crystal oscillator, then in that you will be having one crystal. You see, this is our crystal. And in this crystal, we provide biasing capacitor C1 and C2 over here, and this resistor R. And here we have one inverter that is connected in between these two terminals. Now, if you observe this inverter, then that will make sure one thing: if at this terminal signal is logic 0, then at other terminal signal will be logic 1. So that is how opposite voltage will be there in between these two terminals because of this inverter. This C1, C2 and R is biasing elements, right? And working of this crystal oscillator that is based on RC oscillation. Now here we are not talking about this R and this C which you see it in this figure. Because of this crystal there will be resultant capacitance. So here if you observe resultant equivalent circuit of this crystal, then that will be capacitor over here and resistor in series with this. So there will be RC oscillation which will happen because of this crystal, and that will generate clock signal over here. So we can take clock signal from this terminal or from this terminal. Now here there are few things that we need to focus about. If series resistance which is there with this resultant of this crystal is large, in that case oscillation frequency will be low. Why? The reason is that oscillation frequency f, that will be 1 divided by 2 pi RC, where again remember we are not talking about this C1, C2 and R, that is based on equivalent circuit of this crystal. So if series resistor is large, in that case oscillator frequency will be lower. Here we are connecting this R biasing resistor to have stability of clock signal which we generate over here. So here there will be series resonance which happens, as I have told, which is not shown in this figure, but resultant of this crystal will be capacitor in shunt and resistor in series with this circuit. So here internal resistance which is there in series to this crystal will define operation of frequency. If that resistance is having larger value, in that case frequency will be lower. And here we have external load at the terminals, and that will be providing stability to this frequency which we generate over here. As I have said, series resistance defines operation frequency which is there with resonance of this crystal. If you have lower resistance, in that case higher resonance frequency will be there, and if you have higher resistance, in that case your resonance frequency will be lower. And inverter that is used to provide voltage difference in between these two crystal terminal, right? So as I have said, if here we have 0, then here there will be logic 1. And if here we have logic 1, in that case logic 0 will be over here as per this inverter connection that is there across this crystal oscillator. So that is how Pierce crystal oscillator is there, and its resonance frequency will be 1 by 2 pi RC, where C will be shunt capacitance because of this crystal, and R will be series resistance which is there in this circuit, right? So this is how Pierce crystal oscillator is there. Now I'll explain you how we can have generation of two non-overlapping clock. So to have generation of two non-overlapping clock, all we do is we have one simple circuit that you can see, and two non-overlapping clock means what? If you multiply that two clock, in that case resultant will be zero all times, right? So here we will be applying clock signal, and here we will be having non-overlapping clock phi 1 and phi 2. Now let us try to understand what will happen and how it is functioning. So in case 1, I'll consider this clock signal that is equals to 0. So we provide 0 over here and we provide 1 over here after inversion, right? So if you see, this is NOR gate, and as per the operation of NOR gate, if any input is 1, output will be 0. So this 0 that will come in this feedback, right? So 0 0 that will make it to 1. So phi 1 is equals to 1 and phi 2 is equals to 0. Now when clock signal that is equals to 1, at that time 1 will come over here and after inversion 0 will come over here. So as per NOR gate operation, that will make output 0 and 0 will come in feedback. So 0 0 that will make it to 1, so phi 2 will be 1 and phi 1 will be 0. So you see the case which I have shown you, in which if clock is 0, phi 1 that is 1 and phi 2 is 0, and as if clock is 1, then phi 2 is 1 and phi 1 is 0. And this is what non-overlapping clock, what it means, if you multiply these two, then resultant will be 0, that means it is non-overlapping clock. I hope that you have understood this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. The reason is your suggestions matters to me, and based on that, in future I'll be making videos which will solve your queries.